Did you know that John Hayes Hammond Jr. was responsible for developing some of the earliest military drones? Hammond earned the moniker the Father of Radio Control for his pioneering work in the field of radiodynamics. He, along with the many talented engineers who worked alongside him at his research company, laid the foundations for everything from RC cars to military drones in the early part of the 20th century. At the time, naval warfare was far more of a pressing concern than it is today. In the late 19th and early 20th centuries, radio-guided torpedoes were of intense interest to the navies around the globe. An early example was the Sims Edison torpedo, first patented in 1883, which could be controlled remotely by the use of a long wire. The need for a cable made this invention impractical, however, and a wireless version was seen as superior. Beginning in 1909, during his final year at Yale, Hammond set his sights to this problem and consulted the famed inventor Nikola Tesla for advice. Over the next few years, Hammond and his fellow engineers, including Benjamin Messner, the author of Radiodynamics, the Wireless Control of Torpedoes and Other Mechanisms, made breakthroughs in radio control. By 1915, Hammond believed his work with torpedoes was ready to advance beyond the experimental stage and into the development of a practical weapon. Hammond knew that his torpedoes would be a valuable military technology to many nations, but decided to first propose them to his own country. This was especially important in the wake of the sinking of the RMS Lusitania on May 7, 1915, by a German U-boat, which resulted in the deaths of, among others, 128 American citizens, and was one factor that led to the U.S. entering the First World War in 1917. In 1916, the House Appropriations Committee held hearings in reference to the 1917 Fortifications Bill, wherein Hammond and several naval witnesses testified as to the efficacy of his technology. Hammond's Proposal Z, as it was then known, would lay the foundations for a coastal defense system based around the use of his torpedoes, which could be controlled either from land or via aircraft. 11 sites were proposed in all, starting with Fisher Island, New York, then going on to Manila Bay in the Philippines, Honolulu, Hawaii, Puget Sound in Washington State, San Francisco, California, both ends of the Panama Canal, Cape Henry, Virginia, Narragansett Bay, Rhode Island, Boston Harbor in Massachusetts, and Portland, Maine. While the House approved the purchase of Hammond's patents in what became known as the Fisher Island proposal, the U.S. Senate rejected it initially, and the debates continued into the 1920s. Undeterred, Hammond continued working on the technology, and it was finally purchased by the U.S. government 16 years later, in 1932, for the sum of $540,000, or about $10,100,000 in today's money. The timing was fortunate, as the money helped Hammond out with financial difficulties in the wake of the 1929 stock market crash and accompanying Great Depression. Hammond's torpedoes were the drones of his era, allowing for the Navy to strike their opponents from a safe distance by use of radio waves. This concept would be continuously developed in subsequent decades, leading to guided missiles and today's rapid expansion of drone warfare. While the technology has grown more sophisticated, it can all be traced back more than a century to Hammond's groundbreaking experiments. We hope you enjoyed this video, but there's a lot more to explore about John Hayes Hammond Jr., his inventions, and his collection of art and artifacts. We invite you to visit us at Hammond Castle Museum in Gloucester, Massachusetts, to learn more.